Hey everyone, welcome back to another build video. My name is Hexeris, and today I'm going to be showcasing the Verdant Levin by request from the Scrappy Scrapper, who asked for an endgame build around this weapon. So today I will be sharing the build I have set up for this weapon, as well as a tempered Kushala Deora run for it. But let's go ahead and take a look at the setup. Now, on the Insect Glaive, we do have an Affinity Augment, as this will be a focus around Critical Element. Being that Karen's weapons have some of the highest elemental damage in the game, as well as a top contender for elemental damage for versatility among the Elder Dragons. Now, we have the Rathalos Helm and Mail Beta, Karen Long Arms Beta, Nergigante Coil and Greaves Beta, as well as a Master 3 Charm. Now for stats, this will give us the Rathalos Mastery, which increases elemental damage when landing critical hits, which is somewhat of a staple due to our 100% affinity and maxed elemental damage, which I'll get to here in a moment. Next we have the Attack Boost 5 for the plus 15 attack and 5% affinity, so far bringing our base affinity to 15% with the weapon augment. Next we have Thunder Attack 4 to bring the weapon's cap to a Thunder rating of 470. Next, we have Critical Eye 4 for an additional 15% affinity, bringing our base now to 30%. Weakness Exploit 3, giving us that 50% affinity to weak points. And finally, Maximum Might 2 for the additional 20% affinity when at full stamina, which will bring our base to 50% before Weakness Exploit. Now, with all that being said, let's go ahead and take a look at how we socketed the gear to achieve these stats. Okay, so we have a Bolt Jewel in both the Rathalos Helm and Mail, an Attack and Expert Jewel in the Kirin Gloves, a Tenderizer Jewel in the Nergigante Coil, and a Mighty Jewel in the Nergigante Legs. But let's go ahead and take a look and see how this build fares against a Tempered Kushala Deora. Alright, and we're going to go ahead and start in the wrong area. Let me just go ahead and fast travel to the right one here real quick. Then we're going to go ahead and equip flash pods, as those are pretty much a staple for any Kushala fight. As soon as I get to the other side of the wall here, I am going to pop a demon powder, though. Throw on the rock steady mantle so I can collect my buffs here. Oop, got orange, that's okay. Oop, let me put the weapon away since he's already flying. Flash him down and just get started real quick. Mark him and go to town. Oop. And then we're just gonna keep swinging away as much as possible. As you can see, I mean, the damage is actually fairly respectable. Ooh, nice blast damage, and he's down. Now, we didn't take Handicraft because no matter how much Handicraft you take, this weapon will stay in blue sharpness all the way to plus 5. So I figured why even bother with the extra, you know? Just keep swinging. But the thunder damage is actually surprisingly keeping this weapon doing a lot of damage. Just put this away. We'll get ready to flash him down here. There we go. Go back to swinging away. Mark him. Oop. Oh, those wings are annoying. There we go. Downed again. Oop. Turn around. His head likes to reposition when you're standing in front of it. Alright, I learned a nifty little trick here. Let's go ahead and see if I can do it. Get ready to sharpen. We'll go ahead and flash here. And it sets off those bombs. Alright, let me go ahead and just recollect some buffs here. That wind blast. Let me get out of this area real quick. There we go. Go ahead and mark him again. Oop. let's actually flash him. And we'll just mark him with an R2. There we go. Man, those wings are absolutely obnoxious. There we go. Brought him down again. We'll just keep swinging away. But even on the non-weak points, because Elemental has somewhat of a flat damage additive, it's actually doing a significant amount of damage. Okay. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and pop a max potion here real quick. Flash him down. Let me mark him again real quick since my pseudocast seems to have enough stamina to go around. Alright. Get out of the way of that. Let's bring him back down. Just grab a couple of my buffs here. That should be decent enough. I don't need the white just yet. Oh, his face is broken. He's probably close to dead, that means. Looks like my Palico hit him. Not sure why I flashed there. Let's get the white buff now. Come on. There we go. I messed that up. I just don't want him to run. So when he's going crazy like this and it's hard for me to get in because that wind blast, I just usually keep my Kinsect attacking him. See, yeah, as soon as I go in, I get hit by that wind. Makes it real hard to get on top of him. You get just at the right range, though. There we go. All those clouds built up. Created a nice little burst of damage there for me. And he's limping. Okay. I'm gonna flash him out of the air. I'm not gonna bother sharpening since, he's almost dead here. And even at green... and he's dead! Even at green sharpness, the thing was still hitting pretty decently. What was the time on that? Alright, 6 minutes even. So, the damage is surprisingly powerful despite Elemental being heavily underappreciated for most of the other weapons currently being used. I wanted to thank you all for taking the time to watch my video. If you did enjoy the content, please like and subscribe. If you would like to see a build around a particular weapon, feel free to leave a request in the comments below. And as always, happy hunting!